In this part, we continue the project implementation in HEC-GeoHMS within the ArcMap program. And after we explained in previous videos the method of locating bridge hydraulic structures and other structures in the basin of the study area using the subbasin divide tool, where we set the site of the structure in this subbasin and we define this subbasin into two parts. The result was shown in the project point one layer titled Water Treatment of Type 2 Junction. Now, in this part, we will explain the method of locating the dams or receivers sites in the study area basin for the purpose of using them later in the implementation of the project within the HEC-HMS program. To do so, we tick the dam layer and we open the table of this layer. Then we press on select features. And we choose the first dam, which is Dibbs Dam. Then the second dam, which is Sartic Dam, then the third dam, which is Tuktuk Dam. And the last dam, which is Dokan Dam. For the purpose of locating the sites of these dams or reservoirs in the study area basin for the purpose of using them later in the implementation of the project within the HEC-HMS program, we do the following. We go to the third menu from the HEC-GeoHMS menu bar titled Basin Processing, and in it we choose Import Patch Points. Then OK. A new layer appears in the table of content titled Patch Point, where we open the table of this layer and in it we add a new field via table option. Then add field, and in the type we choose exit. Then we type the name, which is SRC type. Then OK. Then we go to the editor. Editor, then start editing, and we choose the price point layer, then OK. Then we press on create feature, and we choose price point. And we choose patch point. Then we go to the first dam, which is Dibbs Dam on the main water course of river, and we make a left click on it on the main water course. As we see, the dam appears on the table. The dams appears in the, on the table, where we type the name, which is Dibbs, and in the description we type dam 1. Name Dibbs, and in the description we type dam 1. Then in patch done, we type 0. In snap on, we type 1. And in the SRC type, we type outlet. Thus, we locate the location of the rest of dams or reservoirs in the study area basin, as we see. Now that we have located the dam sites or reservoirs on the main watercourse of the river in the study area basin, we go to the editor, then stop editing. Then yes. And now we are locating the location of all these dams, where we go to the third menu from the HEC-GeoHMS menu bar titled Basin Processing, and in it we choose delineate patch points. A window titled Delineate Patch Points appears, and in it we specify options. As we see, then OK. We wait for implementation to complete. Then a message appears indicating that four patch points proceed from four points, then OK. Thus, subbasins for the dams in the study area basin were identified, as we see. Then we open the table of the project point one layer. Then we open the table of the project point one layer. And in it we see the dams of the study area basin. Now, the next important step must be taken, where we go to the editor, then start editing, and we choose a project point one layer. Then OK. Then we go to the type field and we type 5 for the first dam. Then in the HYELEM type, we choose reservoir for the first dam, and so on for the rest of dams or reservoirs, as we see. Then we go to the editor. Then stop editing. Then yes. Thus, the dams or reservoir sites were designated on the main water course of the river in the study area basin for the purpose of using them later in the implementation of the project within the HEC-HMS program. Now we save the project by pressing on save.